welcome to my second video for Creative Kilwinning as part of the film group. This is a bit about sound in film, and we're going to work with boom pole today. So your boom pole is basically used for if you have, oh, this is my subject, George, by the way. And basically your boom pole is for if you have, say, an interview, you have maybe a camera set up about here in shot, it's taking video of George there, and you want to get in some sound, but say you don't have a clip mic, you're not able to access a clip mic, or you don't have anything, but you have a boom pole, you can then set up and put your mic as close as you can to that subject or where the sound is coming from without getting in shot, getting in the cameraman's way. You can move about without disrupting your shot. You can also use it for two-way dialogue, so say you don't have two clip mics, you want to go between the two people. It means you get your, maybe you get the one person talking, then you flip it, you can move it about. Or if you're, say, doing a walking shot, you can walk about and do this. You can also get room audio and go to where all the action is at all time. Rather than just one stationary mic going one direction, you can move it around. It's about versatility, being able to move. So basically with your boom pole, to get it extended and get it out, you want to, sounds basic, but a common problem that we always have found with boom poles is that people always break them because they don't know how to use one. So what you want to do is grab underneath these little bits here. There's 1, 2, 3 on my boom pole. You want to basically grab underneath one, twist the wee metal bit here, this wee metal bit to the left, and that loosens that out. And then when you when I open that, if I hold that and then tighten it to the right, if I tighten it to the right, not the left, that's my boom pole in place. It's not going to go anywhere. So you can extend that again underneath it here, tighten it to, or twist it to the left, and then you've got an extension, tighten it back up. So you never want to twist too hard. If it's not moving, it's not coming out, it's normally because you're not twisting the right way, you're not holding it in the right place, and you're just twisting the pole round, which can then damage the boom pole. Now, a common problem also with your boom poles, especially if it's not your own kit, is that the when you get given a boom pole, is that these bits on top that make a sort of holder isn't made for the boom pole. Sometimes I've been given a boom pole, and I've been given microphones, and this top bit doesn't fit onto the boom pole that I've been given. Now, that means you're completely dead in the water, useless. You can't use the boom pole that you've been given. So what you've got to always test that this is fitting on. This is just a standard microphone stand. I've taken it off the top of a microphone stand that you'd use on a stage, and I've popped it on top of my boom pole. Now, the issue with using this, and not us, I don't have a specific directional microphone top that actually fits on top of my boom pole. So I have to use this microphone stand. And when I get my microphone, now these are directional shotgun mics. So because they're a lot thinner, it wouldn't normally fit inside of a standard microphone because they're a lot thinner and they're shotgun mics, which means they're just thin. So what I've done here is I've wrapped a layer of duct tape round my microphone, and then that just makes it fit snug in, and that means not going anywhere. That's just a sort of quick tip to make your kit adapt around you. Obviously, the ideal situation would be you have a top that fits on top of your boom pole and fits your microphone, but in case you don't have that kind of setup, then you can put a bit of tape around your microphone and it will fit into any adapter. Now, when using your microphone, you want to always So I'll extend this out here, pop that on, other way, see, already getting it wrong. When using it, you always want to wrap your wires, so when you're plugged into your Zoom or whatever kit you're using, you want to wrap that around, wrap your wires around, because you get this sort of wire sound. If this is all moving about, it hits your pole, and that will then take away, and it also, if it's all moving up here, you can get buzzes from the electronics, not the wire sort of coming in and out and moving contact between the XLR and your microphone. So what you want to do is you want to wrap it around as much as you can, or as much as you feel comfortable, and then you want to hold it. I hold it this hand like that. This hand back here goes on like that. It holds, I wrap that around my thumb just like that, and then I hold it with my hand. So that means I can now hold this, pop it over my shoulder. You always want to pop it over your shoulder, and then you can hold it down. So That means I can sit and do this for a prolonged period of time without any issues. I'm not going to cause myself any strain. I can rest it on my shoulders. And then if need be, and I need to get a bit more extension to get a bit more outshot or get a bit more further over, I can lift it up like this and push it, or even push it like that and get a bit more. So you can move it as much as you want. You're not getting any sound from your microphone stand. You can move it round. You can do whatever you like. So the way you want to set your microphone up as well, you always got to make sure that the front of your microphone here is facing wherever the sound is coming from. Otherwise, because these are directional mics, if you're pointing it just up from your subject, then you won't get as much sound. The clear quality is not going to be as good and it won't be as clear. So I want to put that bit down, give myself a bit more wire, put it back up, round, and then again, I could adjust if I was trying to get George here. Adjust it like that. Point right down to his mouth. That means I'm like that. Points at his mouth. I would even maybe put that down again. So straight, as much as I can get, direct line to his mouth. So that means I can hold my boom pole. I'm not causing myself any damage. You're obviously going to get some strain when you hold a boom pole because they're just quite difficult to hold on to. They're not the most ideal source of working. But while I'm here, it means I can, if I have my subject there, maybe even a subject over here, I can move my boom pole with slight twists of this hand here. I can twist, and that means it goes between the two sources of sound. It means you're continuously pointing it in the direction of where the sound is coming from, and you're getting the best quality that you can. Now, the next thing we're going to go on to, and we'll see in the next video, is a bit about how to set up our subject, or subject like myself, with a clip mic and how to plug that into your Zoom and get it all working. And then we'll have another video on how to use a Zoom and get that working, test levels, how to do all these things. So I hope you now understand how to use your boom pole. One more thing before I go. You always got to watch. If I have a big length of cable, always watch where your cables are going. You always want to be in control of that, whether it's to tuck it into your side or put your Zoom here, whether you've got a satchel to put your Zoom in, anything. You always want to make sure you're in control of these wires, whether it's holding it underneath. If I was to have loops of wires lying about, you don't want people to be tripping over them. So you always want to, obviously there's no Zoom plugged into the end of this, but if my Zoom's down there, I want to wrap that wire around here again, and then ring it up like so, so that I can then hold that without causing any issues. You don't want any wires. You ideally want to use as little as much as you can to make sure it's not hanging around and nobody can trip over them. Always got to think the safest possible way to do these things. So, see you in the next video.